In the winter of 1928, an inventor from Pennsylvania claimed to have done the impossible. His name was Lester J. Hendershot, and inside a small workshop surrounded by coils, magnets, and copper wires, he said he had created a machine that could draw power directly from the magnetic field of the Earth itself. Newspapers called it a fuel-less generator, a device that could change the world forever. For a brief moment, it seemed as if humanity had found the key to infinite energy. Hendershot was not a scientist by training, but a self-taught engineer, fascinated by radio circuits and aviation. He claimed his breakthrough came while studying the magnetic compasses used in aircraft, noticing strange interactions between coils and magnets when placed in certain positions relative to the Earth's field. From that observation, he began constructing a new type of generator, one that required no gasoline, no moving parts, and no external power source. It was, in his own words, a magnetic resonance converter, an energy machine that simply harnessed what was already around us. The prototype he presented in early demonstrations was small, just a compact frame of wood and metal wound with coils and capacitors, but witnesses reported that it powered small motors and light bulbs effortlessly. To those who saw it, the effect was both thrilling and terrifying. Electricity poured from a device that consumed nothing. Newspapers soon carried stories describing the invention that could make engines obsolete. At the time, America was caught between awe and skepticism. The late 1920s were years of wild innovation. Aviation, radio, and electrical miracles seemed to emerge every month. But even then, a machine that created energy from nowhere violated the foundation of physics itself. Yet Hendershot spoke with conviction, insisting that he was not breaking any laws of nature, only using forces science did not yet fully understand. According to accounts later published in small magazines, the famous aviator Charles Lindbergh reportedly took interest in Hendershot's device. Some stories suggest that Lindbergh saw a demonstration and even tested the motor connected to it, confirming that it indeed ran without fuel. Whether this is truth or myth remains uncertain, but it added immense allure to the legend. Suddenly, the Hendershot generator was whispered about in hangars and scientific clubs as the invention that could revolutionize flight. Hendershot dreamed that his generator could one day power airplanes indefinitely, making refueling unnecessary. He imagined a world where homes and cities could draw power directly from the planet, silent and endless. But soon after these early demonstrations, the tone of his story changed. What began as triumph quickly turned to suspicion, secrecy, and tragedy. The military reportedly took interest in his designs, and men claiming to represent powerful investors began visiting him. Some offered funding, others offered veiled warnings. Within months, Hendershot withdrew from public demonstrations, saying he needed to perfect the design. By the early 1930s, rumors spread that his lab had been searched and his notes confiscated. Skeptics argued that his invention was an illusion built on hidden batteries or clever electromagnetic induction. But others who claimed to have replicated his circuits insisted there was something real behind it, a delicate resonance between tuned coils and the geomagnetic field that could generate low but continuous power. The controversy deepened with every retelling. What was certain, however, was that Hendershot's generator disappeared as suddenly as it had appeared. For decades afterward, scattered enthusiasts tried to rebuild it using diagrams allegedly copied from Hendershot's notebooks. Most failed, producing nothing but faint sparks. A few claimed success, but offered no solid proof. The Hendershot generator became one of the great ghosts of scientific history, an invention that lived only in rumor and the memories of a few aging witnesses. In the 1950s, Hendershot resurfaced briefly, once again claiming to have perfected his generator. This time, the world was different. The age of nuclear power had dawned, and the dream of free, limitless energy was again in the air. Once more, he began to build prototypes in the hope of finally bringing his vision to the public. He demonstrated a model that supposedly produced 50 to 100 watts of power, enough to light several bulbs without any fuel or input current. A few engineers who saw it admitted that it behaved strangely but could not explain the mechanism. The press picked up the story once more, and suddenly the quiet inventor was again a man surrounded by curiosity and controversy. But fame was not kind to him. By this time, Hendershot had become a nervous, paranoid figure, often speaking about people who wanted to suppress his work. He told friends that certain agencies were watching him, that they did not want a machine which could make energy companies irrelevant. Whether those fears were justified or the product of exhaustion and obsession is still debated. What happened next turned his story from mystery into tragedy. In February of 1961, Lester Hendershot was found dead in his workshop in New Stanton, Pennsylvania. The official report stated that he had hanged himself with an electrical cord. The death was ruled a suicide, and the case was closed. But to those who knew him, the explanation never felt complete. He had been working on yet another prototype in the weeks before his death, reportedly excited about a new discovery. Some said he had just secured a potential deal to mass produce his generator. Others claimed he was planning a demonstration for the press. None of these plans aligned with the picture of a man preparing to end his life. Rumors circulated that his workshop had been searched before investigators arrived. Some claimed that his papers and coils were missing, his notebook gone. Neighbors recalled strange visitors in unmarked cars days before his death. Whether these are distortions of memory or fragments of truth remains uncertain, but they form the foundation of the mysterious death legend that still surrounds him today. The absence of a thorough investigation led many, including his family, to suspect foul play, theorizing that his innovative work posed a significant threat to large energy corporations. Rumors circulated that Hendershot had been warned by a major corporation, which he declined to name, to cease all work related to his generator, underlining the potential disruption his invention could cause to their lucrative business. Allegedly, Hendershot accepted $25,000 under the condition that he halt his research for 2 decades. He had expressed fears for his safety to his family, indicating the gravity of the threats he faced. Hendershot's death and the suppression of his invention continue to provoke deep questions. Skeptics argue that Hendershot's death was a tragic suicide driven by frustration, financial hardship, and the ridicule of mainstream science. They point out that despite decades of claims, no working model ever surfaced that could be independently tested and verified. Engineers who studied his surviving diagrams described them as incomplete and inconsistent. The scientific verdict, they say, is clear. There was no such thing as a free energy generator. Yet even in that skepticism, questions linger. Why did credible witnesses report seeing the machine work? Why did military representatives and corporate engineers travel to meet him if his device was a hoax? And why, after his death, were his prototypes and notes never recovered? The absence of answers fuels the enduring myth of suppression. Those who believe in his discovery argue that Hendershot stumbled upon an unknown electromagnetic resonance, something akin to what later inventors would call zero-point energy. They claim he discovered how to tap into the constant flow of magnetic energy produced by the Earth, converting it into electrical power without violating conservation laws. In that sense, his machine wasn't creating energy, it was harvesting it. But without his original working model, this remained speculation. The surviving circuit diagrams are simple yet perplexing. They show two large coils wound in opposite directions, connected to capacitors, transformers, and a permanent magnet. The entire system forms a resonant feedback loop, where oscillations supposedly amplify themselves through magnetic coupling. Some modern experimenters believe that under exact tuning, such a circuit could generate small currents from ambient electromagnetic noise, but nowhere near the level of output Hendershot described. And yet, over a century later, people still attempt to rebuild it. On obscure forums and research websites, enthusiasts exchange blueprints, speculate about coil turns and resonance frequencies, and speak of the lost key to over-unity. To them, Hendershot is not a fraud, but a pioneer who was silenced before his time. They argue that what killed him was not despair, but suppression. In that narrative, Hendershot's death mirrors that of other controversial inventors, men who claim to have tapped into forbidden energies only to die abruptly before revealing their secrets. Some link him to names like Nikola Tesla and Thomas Henry Murray, inventors whose devices allegedly defied mainstream explanation. To believers, Hendershot's fate is part of a larger pattern, a quiet war against discoveries that could dismantle global energy control. Whether real or imagined, it gives his story the gravity of a lost revolution. In one of his last notes, he reportedly wrote that energy is everywhere, if you know how to look. Today, the Hendershot generator survives in digital blueprints circulating across the internet, reinterpreted by enthusiasts using modern components. They continue to experiment, hoping to rediscover what Hendershot may have known. Did Lester Hendershot truly find a way to draw power from the Earth's magnetic field? Or was he simply another dreamer lost in his own invention? The answer lies buried somewhere between science and myth, between genius and tragedy. His machine may have been nothing more than an elaborate resonance circuit, or it may have been something far more profound. What cannot be denied is that the mystery of his death keeps the legend alive.